I'm going to be playing various selections of music for you this evening. My good news is that I was chosen to be the fairy princess in my school play. This is my special dress.
Is it?
But the true test of any hotel, as you well know, Diane, is that morning cup of coffee, which I'll be getting back to you about within a half hour.
This is, excuse me, a damn fine cup of coffee. I've had I can't tell you how many cups of coffee in my life, and this is one of the best.
We'll make a fresh pot of coffee.
We're gonna need some more coffee.
Can we offer you gentlemen a cup of joe?
Mrs. Packard said the magic word.
Fresh coffee.
I'd love a cup, thanks.
How do you take it?
Black as midnight on a moonless night.
Do you like coffee?
Mr. Cooper here might want to try a slice of that pie.
A cherry pie?
Best in the Tri-Counties.
Fellas, don't drink that coffee. You'd never guess. There was a fish in the percolator.
We're gonna need some more coffee.
Damn, I still can't get the taste of that fish filling the coffee out of my mouth.
Me neither.
Anyone for a warm-up?
Oh, yeah, you bet.
Damn good coffee. And hot. They got a cherry pie there. That'll kill you.
Coffee.
Short stack of griddle cakes, melted butter, maple syrup, lightly heated, slice of ham. Nothing beats the taste sensation when maple syrup collides with ham.
How would you like some fresh huckleberry pie?
I would love a slice of pie. Norma, slice of huckleberry pie, heated, vanilla ice cream on the side, coffee.
Coming right up.
Coffee's free.
Sound of that.
Afternoon, guys. Would you like some coffee?
Afternoon, Shelley, yes.
Well, we should be on our way.
Harry, I'm going to let you in on a little secret. Every day, once a day, give yourself a present. Don't plan it. Don't wait for it. Just let it happen. It could be a new shirt at the men's store, a catnap in your office chair, or two cups of good, hot, black coffee. Like this.
A present. Like Christmas.
Coffee.
Nothing like a great cup of black coffee.
I'll have a bear claw.
I'll have a cheeseburger.
I've got cookies. No cake.
What kind of cookies?
Sugar.
Who do you have to grease to get some coffee around here?
The coffee.
Coffee.
Can I get a cup of coffee to go?
So what's with the coffee?
Coffee?
Coffee.
You don't have coffee at home.
Coffee.
The cream and sugar.
We're gonna need some more coffee.
For what we are about to receive, may the Lord make us truly thankful.
Amen.
Robert, I was hoping we'd have the chance to discuss the events of the past few days. necessarily the physical events themselves, but rather the thoughts and feelings surrounding them. Rebellion in a young man your age is a necessary fact of life. Candidly, it sounds strange. In other words, Robert, I respect your rebellious nature. However, being your father, I am obligated to contain that fire of contrariness within the bounds established by society, as well as those within our own family structure. Robert, I note your reluctance to enter into a dialogue with me, your father. There are times when silence is golden. Silence can be taken many ways as a sign of intelligence. The quieter we become, the more we hear. Now, I am a tolerant man. My patience has its limits. To have his path made clear is the aspiration of every human being in our beclouded and tempestuous existence. Robert, you and I are going to work to make yours real clear.
We're here for you, Bobby. This is the kind of shit I'm talking about.
Oh yeah, pretty good.
Watches again.
A little boy went out to play. When he opened his door, he saw the world. As he passed through the doorway, caused a reflection. Evil was born. Evil was born and followed the boy.
I'm sorry. What is that?
An old tale. And the variation.
Which could be effective.
So he like finds it, then, you know, builds on it and make a piece. Some pieces are short, some pieces are long, but they all live within this certain thing that's found.
I've been hypnotized or something.
Hypnotized? Who hypnotized you?
man moved his hands. And he said that I would know who it was.
How are you going to kill this person?
With a screwdriver.
Robert, this may be a good time for a brief discussion.
You want to talk about cigarettes? Today?
No, but put it out. It's a filthy habit, especially for a varsity athlete. We have a responsibility to the dead, Robert. Responsibility is the linchpin of our society. Each man responsible for his own actions, each action contributing to the greater good.
What's the good of putting someone in the ground?
It's man's way of achieving closure. And ceremony begins understanding and will to carry on without those we must leave behind. Robert, in your life, you must learn. You will learn to carry on without you.
Great.
I realize you experience an ongoing disinclination to enter fully into meaningful exchange. This leads to stalemate. A desire on my part to force certain wisdom upon you. Isn't necessarily a bad thing. Sometimes it's the best course available. Son, don't be afraid. We'll all be there together.
Afraid of what?
The funeral.
I'm not afraid of any damn funeral. Afraid? I can hardly wait. Afraid? I'm gonna turn it upside down!
Why you been here? Okay, now listen. Quit the drugs, okay?
Yeah.
We'll start you in on meditation really soon, okay?
Yeah. Really? why we from the first thing a fresh tongue.
Hey, don't cry, hey, no word.
And there's a voice loose you can hear.
First, some sirens, my arms bend.
Reaping what he'd been sowing, that's what. They say, fucker been sowing some kind of heavy shit.